Hey guys, it's Aaron. So I saw, well, I've seen lots of questions about this particular thing. What do you do when you have a bunch of lines and you go to connect them, but a face doesn't show up? So I started kind of exploring the different problems that can cause this, and I think I came up with six that were fairly realistic. Everything else I could come up with was a variant of one of these six ways that a set of geometry won't close. So let's go ahead and hop in and take a look at what those are. Okay, so you'll notice I said six, but there's seven sets of lines here. Well, that's because we're going to show you what should happen, of course. So if I come over here, I have three lines, one, two, three, and I draw a line connecting these two ends right here. Everything happens to be an axis that shouldn't be, that should have no bearing on what we're actually doing. But when I connect the two points, a face shows up. That's normal. That's what should happen. All right, so let's look at the first example here. I want to go ahead and go click, click. Oh, and it did not close. So I would say one of the more common reasons this happened is because a face shows up when a set of lines closes. So anytime you have a situation where you have those lines and they don't close, there's a chance that there's a gap in the lines. So generally speaking, if you kind of spin around and take a look at the corners, it seems like depending on your model, depending what you're working on, you may have a situation where you have a corner that doesn't quite close. So if I, oh, look at this. See this little tiny gap right here? That happens and it prevents your rectangle from closing. So I took the quick way out and I just connected the two points. You'd probably want to figure out how it's supposed to close if that's, this is not actually a rectangle anymore. But anytime you have a set of lines and they don't close, it will not create a face. There is no rounding, there's no guessing. SketchUp doesn't go, oh, these points are close enough. Let's just, well, it does do that, but it's very, very small. In this case, if your points are snapped to different points right here, they don't connect together, it doesn't close, it doesn't count. So over here, we'll go ahead and close this one. And oh, same thing. That's going to be a recurring thing, of course. They're not going to close. The issue with this one is a little easier to see. Right here, I have geometry coming in. Now, this is a thing that SketchUp does. To create a face, you have to have closed geometry. You can't have any loose geometry coming into the plane because it doesn't create a closed rectangle. So this was a closed shape. This one right here, if it followed lines around, it has a line that comes in and doesn't go back out. It doesn't close. So this is not actually a closed shape. So as long as there's any lines coming into the geometry, this is going to be an issue. So if I get rid of that line I just created, I'll just get rid of this little line right here. Now, if I draw a line, oh, we're good. That one closes. Okay, keep on moving our way down here. I'm going to draw another line here to here. Uh-oh. Again, doesn't close. What's going on? Well, one of the things you can do, a way that you can go and check for that loose geometry that I showed before is to do a group select. So if I come in here and do a group select like this, if there's loose geometry, it'll show up here in entity info. Whoa, four edges. Well, that could be an issue. I should only have three here, but I can't seem to find it, right? One, two, three. Oh, it's broken. What's going on? Okay, well, here's the issue. Again, I have geometry coming in, but I can't see it. Something's going on because this edge is broken, but I can't tell what it is. If you come up to view and turn hidden geometry, this can cause issues. So if you're working on a model that you've worked and reworked in the past, you might have something like this with hidden geometry. So you've smoothed geometry over and then you've deleted geometry and drawn over that geometry. You may have hidden lines. A lot of times people go, well, I got this wall and I can't close it up. And when you go turn hidden geometry, it looks like a spider web because there's so much stuff's been moved around. Again, just like with that little geometry in the corner, this won't close no matter what I do as long as this line's in here, even though it's hidden. So if I turn hidden geometry, delete that, and then draw that, then we close. All right, moving our way down. Here's another one. I'm gonna draw that line in, and of course, it's not gonna close. What's going on here? All right, well, this example is a little trickier because if I do a select, whoops, select just those pieces, Turn that off. I do have just the three edges. That's all correct. The issue here, if I start moving around 3D space, look at that. See how it's just slightly out of plane? This causes problems for people all the time. Sometimes it is so teeny tiny that it's out of plane, it's hard to find. The way that you usually find an out of plane space like this is to do a little stitching. If I connect corner to corner, it closes. But if I delete that, it goes away again. That's kind of an indicator that I have a problem with something being out of plane. You can check your points like this. So this, here's the X, Y, and Z location of this point. If I check every corner, oh, I can see right there. This corner is 1¼ inches higher than the rest of these corners. So what I'd want to do is, in this particular case, I'd probably use move to grab this point and move it vertically to the same height as this. Then when I draw that last line on, it closes up. That didn't update. Get out of there. So that's the thing to look for also. All right, we're getting there. We're almost there. I'm gonna draw another line right here, and surprise, surprise, it's not gonna close. We still have hidden geometry on, so that's not the problem. If I select here, five edges again, that's weird. What's going on there? Oh, I got another broken line. That's usually an indicator, like I said, that something could be going on. In this case, if I go to tags, and I have this hidden tag, oh, look at that, I had a line on a hidden tag. So just because you can't see geometry doesn't mean it's not still interfering with what you're trying to do. If something's not acting the way it's supposed to, check hidden geometry. That doesn't work. Check hidden tags. So again, I'm just going to delete that line, draw right over top of this, and it closes. All right, one last one here. I'm going to go ahead and connect these two points on, and surprise, it doesn't work. What's the deal? Well, if I click here, and notice some, wait, I click one line, looks like it all lights up. I got a flickering line down here. If I look up here, it says it's a group. Well, that'll do it, right? So this right here, if I double click, this is a group that those four lines are in. No matter what I do on the outside here, I am never going to get this to close. Turning on hidden tags, nothing's going to fix this because I can't interact with geometry inside of a container. So I have to do one of two things. One is to right click and explode to get it out. Or if I want to keep it separate, just double click to enter the group and then draw my line there. And then it closes. So like I said, there are some other situations I could think of where you have geometry that doesn't quite close up when you want it to. But all of those other situations were kind of variants or slight changes to this. These were all the situations I could think of, unique situations. I know the hidden line versus hidden tag was similar, but it could be lumped together under geometry that's hidden that prevents from closing. But there's two different ways to fix it, so I figured it merited its own example. So yeah, let me know if there's another way that you see that you get geometry that doesn't close, and let me know if this helps you. If you've ever had geometry that didn't close, and maybe there's a tip in here that helps you close it, let me know about that too. If you like that video, click like down below, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. We create several videos every single week, and you'll be notified of each and every one of them if you subscribe. Most importantly, though, please leave a comment down below. We make most, if not all, of our content nowadays based on comments from viewers like you. We like making these videos a lot, but we like them even more when they're showing something you want to see. Thank you.